हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम सरका सरवत फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ जूलॉजी ऑफ JTR साइंस एंड कॉमर्स कॉलेज फॉर वुमेन, मालेगांव, नासिक। डियर स्टूडेंट, इन द अर्लियर लेक्चर वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस अबाउट सम पॉइंट इन द डाइजेशन एंड अब्सॉर्प्शन, दैट इज मोटिलिटी। नाउ इन दिस प्रेजेंटेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट सिक्रिटरी फंक्शंस और सिक्रीशंस ऑफ GIT. The total volume of GIT secretions is about 6 to 8 liter per day. एक दिन में जो total volume है GIT secretion का वो 6 to 8 liter रहेगा। GIT secretions arise from specialized cells lining the GI tract, the pancreas, liver and gall bladder. ये secretion कहाँ से होंगे? जो स्पेशल टाइप के सेल प्रेजेंट है GI लाइनिंग में, गैस्ट्रो इंटेस्टिनल ट्रैक की जो लाइनिंग में प्रेजेंट सेल्स हैं, या फिर जो एक्सेसरी ग्लैंड्स प्रेजेंट है, दैट इज पैंक्रियाज, लीवर एंड गॉल ब्लैडर। तो ये सारे ग्लैंड एंड स्पेशलाइज्ड सेल प्रेजेंट इन द लाइनिंग ऑफ GI, दीज आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द सिक्रीशन ऑफ डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ enzyme which are involved in the process of lubrication, protection, sterilization, neutralization and digestion. For lubrication there is a secretion of water and mucus. For protection there is a secretion of mucus. For sterilization, secretion of hydrochloric acid. For neutralization, secretion of bicarbonate ion, and for digestion there is a secretion of different types of enzyme. Now secretion of GIT in mouth. In that, first of all, salivary gland. Three pairs of glands are present. Here we can see in the photograph there is a presence of three pairs of salivary gland present. First of all, that is the parotid gland, and this is the submandibular gland and sublingual gland. Okay, these three pairs of salivary gland are present in the buccal cavity. Three pairs of gland: parotid, sublingual, submandibular. After that, functions of saliva which is secreted from the salivary gland. First is lubricate, cleans oral cavity, dissolves chemicals, suppresses bacterial growth, digest starch by amylase. Amylase, it is secreted or it is present in the saliva. After that, regulation of salivary secretion. Here by the arrow we can easily understand the regulation of salivary secretion from the salivary gland. Here the cerebral cortex. Cerebral cortex gives a positive feedback on the salivary center in the medulla region of brain. There are two conditions. First is conditioned reflux. Another one is unconditioned reflux. In the conditioned reflux, the salivary center in medulla gives the positive feedback towards the autonomic nervous system, which stimulate the salivary gland for the secretion of salivary enzymes or saliva. In unconditioned reflux, the pressure receptor and chemoreceptor in the mouth stimulate the medulla region. Okay, the pressure receptor and chemoreceptor in the mouth, it gives the positive reflux towards the salivary center in the medulla and it stimulate the autonomic nervous system. Ultimately, it stimulates the salivary gland for the secretion of saliva. Okay. Now next, GIT secretion in stomach. Here we can see very easily the lumen of stomach. There is a presence of gastric gland and there is a presence of opening of gastric gland. Here the photograph, it is the outer wall of the stomach and its zoom figure is here. Okay, here we can see the different type of cell and their secretion and their function. First of all, parietal cell, which is present here. Okay, parietal cells. These parietal cells secreted gastric acid, and that is hydrochloric acid, also some intrinsic factor. Gastric acid or HCl, it involved in the activation of pepsin and also kills the bacteria which is present in the food material. Intrinsic factor involved in the complexes with vitamin B12 to permit absorption. Next is chief cells. These chief cells secreted the pepsin or pepsinogen or gastric lipase. Pepsin or pepsinogen involved in the digestion of protein. Gastric lipase involved in the digestion of fat. After this, mucus neck cell. Mucus neck cell, these are involved in the process of physical barrier between the lumen and epithelium, and it secreted the mucus. Okay, next is G cell secreted the gastrin, which stimulate the gastric acid secretion. These are some GIT secretion in stomach. Function of gastric HCl, very important. It activates the pepsinogen into pepsin in its active form. It provides the optimum pH for action of pepsin. Denatures protein, that is denaturation or its digestion, kills bacteria in food, help Fe2+ and Ca2+, means ferrous and calcium absorption. It promotes the pancreatic, small intestine and bile secretion. So now next is function of pepsins. What is the function of pepsin? Pepsinogen in its inactive form, it converted into the pepsin, its active form, by the action of hydrochloric acid at the pH of 2 to 3.5 and convert the pepsin, and this pepsin is involved in the conversion of protein into the peptone. Okay. Now next, function of mucus and intrinsic factor. Mucus secretion. Soluble and insoluble mucus are secreted by cells of stomach. Soluble mucus and insoluble, दो type के mucus form होते हैं और secrete होते हैं from the cells of stomach. So soluble mucus mixes with the content of the stomach and help to lubricate chyme. Chyme, it is the bolus form of food material. Insoluble mucus forms a protective barrier against the high acidity of the stomach content. It helps in the absorption of vitamin B12. So these are some functions of soluble and insoluble mucus. Now next is pancreas. Pancreas, it is the duplex gland, as it contains the endocrine as well as endocrine and exocrine, both part. Okay, so in the pancreas there is a presence of a common bile duct, pancreatic duct. There is a presence of lobule. There is a presence of exocrine part, that is called as the acini. Or these acinar cells secrete the digestive enzyme, which are involved in the process of digestion. Also there is a presence of islet of Langerhans. These islet of Langerhans are the endocrine part of pancreas. So in this photograph we can see the islet of Langerhans. Also there is a presence of cluster of cell, grape like structure called as the acini cell, and these acini cells are very important for the process of digestion because it secrete the digestive enzymes. Pancreatic secretion. Pancreas has two functions. Endocrine function, secrete insulin and glucagon from islet of Langerhans. As insulin and glucagon, it maintain the blood sugar level. Exocrine function, secretion of pancreatic juice. It has two components, aqueous and enzymatic component. Two component कौन कौन से हैं? Aqueous and enzymatic. Okay. So aqueous component, it contains HCO3, that is bicarbonate, is important for neutralizing stomach acid in the duodenum, so pancreatic enzyme can function properly. Next is enzymatic component. It is essential for the proper digestion and absorption of carbohydrate, fat and protein. Pancreatic enzyme include trypsin, chemotrypsin, lipase and amylase. What are the functions of pancreatic juice? Here very descriptive type of slide is present, that is conversion of starch into the maltose and maltotriose by the action of pancreatic amylase at the pH 7. Okay. After that, fat, that is triglyceride, is converted into the monoglyceride and fatty acid by the action of lipase and colipase at the pH of 8. Trypsinogen is converted into the trypsin by the action of enterokinase. Also, this trypsin involved in the conversion of chymotrypsinogen into its active form, that is chymotrypsin, and these both are involved in the conversion of or denaturation of protein into the polypeptide, and this polypeptide with the help of carboxypeptidase form the amino acid, that is the simple form or monomer of proteins. So next point is regulation of pancreatic secretion. How it regulate? First of all, it is the brain, it is the vagus nerve, and it is the stomach. Okay. What happens? Secretion from the duodenum. You can see here, this is the duodenum, and it secretes the secretin. Secretin, it is secreted from the S cell of duodenum, and cholecystokinin, that is called as the CCK. It is secreted by the I cells of duodenum. So I cells and S cells of duodenum are responsible for the secretion of cholecystokinin and secretin. Okay. So because of secretion of secretin, there is a secretion of bicarbonate from the pancreas. Means this is the secretin which is secreted from the duodenum, and it is secreted into the circulation, and alternately it stimulates the pancreas for the secretion of bicarbonate. After that, cholecystokinin secreted from the I cells of duodenum, and it is secreted into the circulation. By the circulation, it activates the pancreas for the secretion of digestive enzyme. And this digestive enzyme and bicarbonate, that is HCO3, both are combinedly formed pancreatic juice. Okay. So this is the regulation of pancreatic. So regulation of pancreatic secretion, very easily we can understand here by this diagram. This is the presence of acid in the duodenum cause release of secretin. Here, presence of acid in duodenum. Acid कहाँ से आएगा? जो food material present है stomach region में, तो pylorus से वो enter होगा into the duodenum. This acidic chyme stimulate the duodenum for the secretion of secretin. And also there is a presence of fat in the duodenum, which is present in the food material, and it stimulate the duodenum for the secretion of cholecystokinin. So by the secretion of secretin or cholecystokinin, there is a secretion of bicarbonate ion and secretion of pancreatic enzyme. Okay, it is the regulation of pancreatic secretion. And the similar thing is explained by this photograph. There is a presence of duodenum. A cell secretes the secretin, and I cell secretes the CCK, that is the cholecystokinin. And alternately, it stimulates Actually, it is secreted into the bloodstream and it stimulates the pancreas for the secretion of pancreatic juice, that is the carbonate ion, bicarbonate ion and enzyme, proenzymes by the pancreas. So it is the regulation of pancreatic secretion. So I hope this video is very informative for you. Keep watching. Thank you.